Even in today's modern world of memes and Twitter feuds, there are still the remnants of the old aristocracy dating back to the Middle Ages. The monarchic families of England, Denmark, Spain, etc. still bestow titles of nobility to notable people, and therefore in every sense of the matter, the nobility is still alive and well in some corners of the world. These aristocrats, in modern usage, referred colloquially and broadly to people who inherited lots of wealth and or noble titles from their parents, are also referred to as blue bloods. However, why is that? Surely the title itself cannot change your blood to blue, and the years of inbreeding is also probably not responsible. So why are people of these higher social statuses called the blue bloods? Well, to find out, we have to go to Spain. More precisely, to 8th century Visigothic Spain, just before the Muslim conquest. The Visigothic kingdom was large, but very unstable and militarily weak. This led to some unfortunate events of political turmoil just as the Muslim invasion of the peninsula started. As a result, the Muslims were quick to take control of much of the peninsula and executed a number of the Visigothic nobility. However, some of the Visigothic nobility managed to escape into the mountainous region of Asturias in northern Spain, and there managed to defend themselves, establishing Regnum Astororum, the last safe haven of Visigothic nobility and Christians in Hispaniola. From there, the centuries-long Reconquista of the Spanish peninsula started, and it's during this time that the term blue blood or sangre azul appears in literature. It was during the Spanish Reconquista against the Muslim enemy that Spanish nobles, tracing their lineage all the way back to the Visigothic kingdom, would lift up their sword arm, displaying the superficial blue blood veins beneath their pale white skin, which was taken as the proof of their noble Visigothic lineage and that their birth has not been contaminated by the enemy, whose skin was a darker color. From there, the term quickly spread across Europe to characterize all nobility, not just of Visigothic descent. However, with that, it also slightly changed its meaning. The term blue blood now meant that as part of the noble family, you were rich enough not to do any manual labor outside in the sun. Therefore, as a result, your skin was naturally paler to those of the peasantry. This resulted in your veins, which appear blue from outside, to be more visible and therefore giving you the term blue blood. This term stuck around throughout history, however, it wasn't used that often till the early 19th century, and it's still used widely today. This video was made in part by Vitae Slovakia, and if you enjoyed the animation work, please go check out his channel by clicking here. If you want to see more videos like this in the future, please share and subscribe by clicking here. Thank you for watching.